Ascension Day, so we're in the season where we celebrate Jesus ascending into heaven. So we celebrate his glory, but we also wait for the coming of the Holy Spirit. The Church of England has published some special form of prayer based around the Psalms for the days between Ascension Day and Pentecost. And there are still some left at the back of the church. If you haven't got one and would like to take it away, it says maybe just prayers for 9 days. But if you only do 8, if you only do 7 of them, I'm sure you'll still get plenty of benefit from it. And as it is a psalm and a sort of reflection of prayer. Also, if you have still got your Christian Aid envelope to return, there is a plate. You can tell which one it is. It's full of Christian Aid envelopes. It's very simple. And I'll just remind any visitors that at the moment we're bringing communion to you, so you don't come up to communion. Just sit down during communion and we come round to you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Please sit for our opening prayer.
That's fine.
Say together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. What God has prepared for those who love him, he has revealed to us through the Spirit. The Spirit searches everything. Therefore, let us in penitence open our hearts to the Lord, who has prepared good things for those who love. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the broken in heart. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You make one by your Spirit the torn and divided. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God forgives all who truly repent. Have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all good. Keep you in life and perfect through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Stand to say the glory of Chelsea together. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks. We praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayers. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
The call. O God, the King of glory, you have exalted your only Son, Jesus Christ, with great triumph to your kingdom in heaven. We beseech you, leave us not comfortless, but send your Holy Spirit to strengthen us, and exalt us to the place where our Saviour Christ has gone before, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please sit for our reading from the Acts of the Apostles.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, Peter stood among the believers. Together, the crowd numbered about 120 people, and said, "Friends, the scripture had to be fulfilled, which the Holy Spirit, through David, foretold concerning Judas, who became a guide for those who arrested Jesus. For he was numbered among us, and was allocated his share in this ministry. So one of the men, who have accompanied us through the time that the Lord Jesus went in and out among us, beginning from the baptism of John until the day he was taken up from us, one of these must become a witness with us to his resurrection." So they proposed two: Joseph, called Barsabbas, who was also known as Justus, and Matthias. Then they prayed and said, "Lord, you know everyone's heart. Show us which one of these two you have chosen to take the place in this ministry and apostleship, from which Judas turned aside to go to his own place." And they cast lots for them, and the lot fell on Matthias, and he was added to the 11 apostles. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. I have made your name known to those whom you gave me from the world. They were yours, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now they know that everything you have given me is from you. For the words that you gave to me, I have given to them, and they have received them, and know in truth that I came from you, and they have believed that you sent me. I am asking on their behalf. I'm not asking on behalf of the world, but on behalf of those whom you gave me, because they are yours. All mine are yours, and yours are mine, and I have been glorified in them. And now I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, protect them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one, as we are one. While I was with them, I protected them in your name that you have given me. I guarded them, and not one of them was lost, except the one destined to be lost, so that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you, and I speak these things in the world, so that they may have my joy made complete in themselves. I have given them your word, and the world has hated them because they do not belong to the world, just as I do not belong to the world. I'm not asking you to take them out of the world, but I ask you to protect them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world, just as I do not belong to the world. Sanctify them in their truth. Your word is true. As you have sent me into the world, This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you,
May I speak in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Are you the sort of person who is a planner, organizer, thinker? You know the sort of thing. Get yourself well prepared in advance for events to come. Have a holiday plans well arranged in advance, celebrations for significant life events, all in order, months, if not years ahead. Or like one of my friends, has a plan A. And if that doesn't work, a plan B, and maybe even a plan C. Now there's even a save the date card sent round, isn't there? And admittedly, this has somewhat been eclipsed by what a previous Prime Minister years ago called events, dear boy, events. But in some form or other, many of us do this. And with situations like the current pandemic, certain issues can be put into focus. For instance, I have recently reviewed my will to ensure it's up to date and reflects my wishes. There is an element where it's important that we have at least some form of a plan for moving on, even if it's tentative. Businesses have forward strategic plans, at least to work around. And I can remember when I was at work having emergency planning exercises as a way to hopefully at least have some form of preparedness for major issues. Also the case when we are faced with the unexpected, the crisis that comes seemingly from nowhere, that at least after a period of time to think about it, work through it to some extent, we need to move on, to work through it and on. I'm sure many of us can recollect such times and events in our lives in one form or another. In bereavement, for example, there are recognized stages of grief and loss. So then, as we consider the readings today, we can see elements of that taking place. Jesus in the Gospel, aware of what was to come, taking time to look at the future for himself and his disciples, the ones who, by being with him and his ministry, experienced his way of life, teaching, miracles. So they were able to speak and witness from first-hand experience and knowledge the truth. We see his love for them, caring, compassion, and trusting in God's protection and guidance. the Ascension. Truly an enormous thing for them to get their head round. Yes, they were together, supporting each other in prayer, worship. But what next, really? Who really knows? Things had changed yet again. No wonder the need for those prayers of Jesus for them to get through. Yes, a time to move on the incredible journey they were now and would experience, to wait and see what God would do next, but also to make practical plans, seeking God's guidance. Whilst doing so, they, as we know, would become witnesses to others. Through amazing experience in ways they perhaps hadn't even dreamed of, enabling the story to continue. So, as we reflect on all of this, at this time, as we celebrate Christ's Ascension, wedding Pentecost, celebration, gift of the Holy Spirit, time of crisis in the world, of change, moving on, both in terms of the pandemic, the economy, climate change, of the church, how we respond nationally, within our diocese, and individually as a church. Seeking how God is asking us to proclaim his message of life, of hope, love, joy, peace to others in this new and different time. God, as we are told and believe, is with us always until the end of the age. It doesn't mean necessarily that God's message us at a particular time is changeless, but what is relevant then. When I was licensed, what was then called a reader, in the service, and in the services of relicensing every 2 years, it talks about the faith the church is called upon to proclaim afresh in every generation. We are each on a journey, a relationship, as we've heard over the last few weeks, calling to abide, to trust, and be fruitful, to follow, to be witnesses, as we are the body of Christ here on earth. Doesn't necessarily mean success, but does often mean transformation and change for us and others as we move on in faith and trust in the power of the Holy Spirit to proclaim afresh the faith in this generation. Amen.
Let us stand now and affirm the faith which we proclaim with our lips and in our lives. one for whom we exist.
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
We believe and trust in him.
This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith.
We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Now, in union with Christ and in the power of the Spirit, let us pray to the Father.
Heavenly Father, who received our Lord Jesus Christ in the embrace of paradise, exalted him to your right hand in glory everlasting, took him from our sight, though no longer from our side. We remember with thanksgiving the promise of his presence with us until the end of the world. He is here with us now. Father, in all the varied circumstances in which our lives are set, may we know Christ beneath us, above us, behind us, before us, and at our side. Lord, in your mercy, pray for our mother, the Church, and especially for the churches which have, like a mother, fed and nurtured our faith, comforted us when we were sad, and taught us the way in which to walk. Lord, in your mercy, you have been with us in our isolation, close to us in our distancing, joy in our sadness, light in our darkness, and wisdom in our confusion. You have been familiar when all has been unfamiliar. We pray that as our nation emerges from the strictures of lockdown, we may act responsibly and cautiously as we enjoy our hard-won freedoms again. Remember those areas in our country which are still under threat from the Indian variant. We pray for those countries still struggling the effects of the pandemic, where healthcare and resources are often scarce, and the virus brings further suffering for the most vulnerable and least able to cope with its devastating effects. Lord, in your mercy, circle us, Lord. Circle our family and friends with the love of the gospel. Keep them in peace and security. Guard those of our loved ones who are vulnerable, those who are struggling. Encourage those who are on the brink of something new. We name these our special people in our hearts now. us to be aware of your presence and to abide in your love, that we may walk in the way that leads to glory, where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Please stand. Jesus says, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. If you love me, rejoice, because I am going to the Father." Alleluia, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Alleluia. Of one another, simply distant.
Button.
indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is our great High Priest, who has entered once for all into the heavenly sanctuary, evermore to pour upon your church the grace and comfort of your Holy Spirit. He is the one who has gone before us, who calls us to be united in prayer, as were his disciples in the upper room, while they awaited his promised gift, the life-giving Spirit of Pentecost. Therefore all creation yearns with eager longing, as angels and archangels sing the endless hymn of praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, the broken bread and wine outpoured, may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised him. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised it, gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood, the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favor on your people, gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with Thomas and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, O loving Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
Sit or kneel for the Lord's prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Ever, ever.
Amen.
Lord, we died with you on the cross. Now we are raised to new life. We were buried in your tomb. Now we share in your resurrection. Live in us that we may live. make spiritual community.
Father,